We really need to improve the visibility of bladder cancer for pharmaceutical companies. And the reason they have gone away from bladder cancer research is because it's very hard to enroll patients in this sphere in our studies due to poor recruitment. So one of the theories that we put forward was based on a prospective study that we did at MD Anderson Cancer Center, where we showed that you can use molecular diagnosis. In this case, it was the FISH test at 6 weeks, but you could use it at 3 months too. But you can use molecular diagnosis of recurrent bladder cancer, or to put it a different way, you can identify when patients have failed molecularly and then get them enrolled in a clinical trial. The advantage of that is, since they haven't actually failed with tumor recurrence, they would be much more amenable, and it would be ethical as well to put them on continuing BCG therapy, which is the valid gold standard control arm, and not necessarily tell the patients that their option should be cystectomy, but if they want to try something completely experimental, would they want to, and that's where they don't enroll.